2020 का जो विजन है, ईयर टू बिल्ड एंड प्रॉस्पर।
Praise the Lord, church. Tonight, I want to welcome you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Tonight, welcome to the Temple of the Most High God Church English Online Service. We are so glad that you have joined us today, and we believe that God is going to do a mighty work in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. So wherever you are, just shout hallelujah. Just say praises to His name. And if you have your Bibles at your house, please take out your Bibles and sit along with your Bible, your pen, your notepad, because God is going to speak to you tonight. Amen. If you have any prayer requests, do type your prayer requests in the comment section, and our prayer team will be praying for you. And you can send your testimonies on the numbers which will be displayed at the end. And you can just share your prayer requests and the testimonies along with us, and we'll be so glad to pray for you. Amen. So before we go into worship, this is the time of worship, and before we go into worship, let's read Mark 11:7 onwards. Mark, the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 7 onwards says, "They brought the colt to Jesus and put their coats on it, and He sat on it. And many spread their coats in the road, and others spread leafy branches which they had cut from the fields. Those who went in front and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest.'" You know, when Jesus was walking into Jerusalem, people were shouting, "Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna." They were not there to seek a miracle. They were not there to say that, "God, Jesus, please heal me because I need you." No, 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 no. They came there just to say, shout, praise God. So tonight, this time you have chosen and you have set this time apart, let's shout praises to His name. Let's say Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the God who sits on above the thrones. Amen. So wherever you are tonight, let's stand and say Hosanna in the highest, because God deserves your worship. He deserves your worship. Tell God that, "God, tonight I come before your throne of grace and mercy. Lord, we thank you for this evening, oh Father God. Lord, it's a privilege to worship you. Lord, we thank you, oh Father God. Lord, tonight, accept our worship. Lord, we lay our priorities at your feet. We lay our pride at your feet. We lay our ego at your feet. We lay everything, oh Father God, at your feet. And Lord, we say that how great you are, oh Father God. You're the name above every name. Jesus, tonight, we look up to you, O Father God. I pray, O Father God, Lord, tonight's service, I commit it into your hands, O Father God. Lord, as people, when you were walking into Jerusalem, people were so happy and rejoicing and shouting, Hosanna, Hosanna. They were singing praises unto you. Lord, tonight, as you are entering, as we are about to worship and you are entering into the houses of people, that people are going to shout, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. The God who saves us. The God who delivers us. The God who is our refuge. You are our strength, O Father God. And Lord, at this time we call upon your name, O Father God. Lord, tonight we have not come here to seek for a miracle. We are not bringing our prayer request tonight, O Father God. But Lord, tonight we are just worshiping you, O Father. We are worshiping the King of Kings and the Prince of Priests. The Creator God. The I Am God. The Emmanuel God. Lord, we come here to worship you, O Father God. Lord, our hearts are full of thanksgiving. Our hearts are full of gratitude, O Father God. And Lord, we say, thank you, O God. Thank you for choosing us, O Father God. Lord, I commit tonight's service into your hands, O Father. Accept our worship. Accept our worship. Lord, let it be a pleasing aroma unto you, O Father God. Lord, as we sing, O Father God, we sing from our hearts. Lord, as we sing, O Father God, it's not just from our mouth, O Father, but Lord, from the bottom of our hearts, we say, Lord, we love you, God. You are my Abba Father. Daddy, we want to say that, Lord, we love you, Father. Come on, church, wherever you are tonight, just lift up your voices and say, Daddy, I love you. Jesus, 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 I love you, Father. Lord, we love you tonight. Lord, we love you. Lord, as we are about to worship you, Father God, Holy Spirit, take over. From this time onwards to the end of the service, Holy Spirit, take over the service. We give you utmost reverence. We give you permission to have your way. Lord, we say that have your way in tonight's service. It's not our plans, our agendas, our strategies, but Lord, Holy Spirit, you would move. Tonight, you're going to do a mighty work in the lives of your people, oh Father God. Tonight, their praises, their worship are going to transform their lives. Tonight, the word is going to transform their lives, oh Father God. Lord, we come before your throne of grace and mercy, and Lord, accept us. Accept us, accept us, oh Father God. Lord, we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, I ask and pray. Amen, amen, amen. Let's shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's clap our hands. I'm sure you have your hands together. So wherever your hands are, just clap your hands and let's sing Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Amen. Let's clap our hands.
Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
clap offering to our God and say, Lord, Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we worship you tonight, O Father God. Jesus.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus, I praise you. My Savior, I praise you. Hosanna in the highest to my King, to my Lord, to my Savior, to my Master. Hosanna in the highest. I praise you, Daddy. I praise you, my King. You are the Lord above every situations in our life. Whatever the situations you are praising tonight, just say, Jesus is Lord over my situations. The debt, the poverty, the disease, the sickness, the confusions, the divorce, the diseases, whatever diseases and the troubles you are having, the lack, the poverty, say, Jesus is Lord over my situation, and I praise Him, and I praise Him. I give Him Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. I praise my King, I praise my Savior. I belong to Him, I belong to Him. He belongs to me. We are one. We are one. When we worship church, when we worship wherever from around the globe, wherever you are watching from, say Hosanna in the highest and say Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is my shepherd and I praise Him. I praise Him. It's not that when an event happens, when an incident happens, there are many people come and see what is happening. When our Lord enters into our life, many people come and see why this sound. Tonight when you're worshiping, you may be watching TV or you may be using a speaker and it may have a maximum volume. And people should ask, why so much volume coming from your home on this 8 o'clock, 8:30 night? You can say, my King is coming. My Lord is coming. I am praising my King. I'm praising my Lord. I'm praising my Savior. I'm alive and I want to say thank you. I'm alive. My family is alive. I have food on my table. I have safety at my home. I am free in Jesus' name and I want to praise my Savior. Let's raise our voice and say, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King, Hosanna to the Lord, Hosanna to my Savior, my Master, my Jesus, the one who saves me, the one who helps me, the one who holds my hand, the one who helps me in every situation, the one who doesn't allow me to go into shameful situations, the one who anoints my head with oil, the one who puts a table in front of my enemies. I praise Him because He doesn't allow me to lose. He always gives me victory. He always gives me victory. He always gives me victory. He always allows me to win. So I praise You. So I praise You. Daddy, I praise You. Hosanna in the highest. Wherever you are watching from right now, worship Him. Raise your hands to heaven and say, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to my King. Think that you are waving hands at your King. He is entering right now into your lives. Wherever you are, more needed Him in your life. If you are needed Him in your body as a healer, invite Him. Say, Hosanna, you are invited, Lord, into my sickness. You are invited into my body. You are invited into my finances. You are invited into all the quarreling which is happening in my home. God of peace, God of peace, God who can proclaim peace over my life, I pray, Hosanna. Oh, come. If you are lacking peace at your home right now, husband and wife, take your hand, hold your hands together and say, Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna, come with you. Let us sing. Hold your hands together and say, Hosanna to the King, Hosanna to the King. As we as husband and wife, as we as men and women of God, as we are holding our hands together, if you're worshiping together in your family, in your home, say Hosanna. You're welcome into our family. You're welcome into our marital life. You're welcome into our home. Lord, you're welcome. You're welcome, my King. Hosanna. Let us raise our voice to heaven and sing that beautiful song by inviting Holy Spirit, our Lord, into our midst, into our families. Say Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
forces, every black magic, every witchcraft which is working against your family, against your marriage, I say cancel it in Jesus Christ's mighty name. As you are singing this beautiful song, as my Savior enters into your family, into your life, every third person, every third spirit, every group, every trust, every organization, anointed, non-anointed, I don't care. If they are working against your family, if they are working against your marital life, I say it is canceled in Jesus Christ's mighty name. The effects of their talks are canceled right now in Jesus Christ's mighty name. You are going to experience marital healing. You are going to experience relationship healing. Tonight, my Lord, Jesus, when Jesus enters into a home, He says to His disciple, when you enter into a house, decree shalom, peace over that household. And my Lord, right now, declaring shalom, peace into husband and wife, quarreling, the confusions which is happening between. I don't know whom I am speaking. I was never prepared for this. I wanted to read a verse from 119 Psalm. But Lord is telling me, right now, minister healing. Minister healing into marital relationships. And I pray tonight as you're going to listen, there is going to be healing in your marital relationship. And I decree and declare, this is the word my good Lord has spoken. And He is going to honor it. Hosanna. Hosanna, my King, my Lord, my Savior. I decree, we as husband and wife, we decree healing on every marriage which requires healing. I decree and declare it. We together agree. Right now in Jesus Christ's mighty name, every husband, every wife, if you are going through a trouble in your marriage, we pray blessings on you. We pray blessings on you. We pray blessings on you. We pray your marriage is going to be healed. Oh, tonight it looks like that I have just come for your family. We are just working for your family. We are just declaring healing on marital relationships over you and your household. Oh, you just want to cry out, cry in front of the Lord and say, oh, thank you, Lord. All the troubles, all the issues, all the emotions which is just jailed in your heart, you want to release, you want to experience a release. If you, as you are crying right now, my Lord is going to release peace over your life. And never again, Lord says, my daughter, my son, never in your life you are going to cry for your marriage. It is always, the cry is going to come, you are going to have joyful cry, joyful tears, the blessings which is going to enter into your household, joyful tears is going to be part of your life tonight. I believe. Let's sing once again, Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
My Savior, I decree and declare peace on every family. I decree and declare peace. I decree and declare peace. The peace which comes from my Master, my Lord, my Savior. No name, no organization, no groups, no religion. No one can give you peace because Jesus holds peace into His hands and He can release it over your household. And tonight I decree and declare peace over your household. Every man and every woman, every group, every person, every organization, every church, every pastor, every anointed, non-anointed man, those who are watching me right now, I decree and declare peace over your household right now in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Oh, we are so thankful to you, Lord. Lord, as we are going to enter into the word, we are going to learn from your word, Father. Lord, anoint me, anoint everyone who is watching us right now, Lord. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray blessings. I pray blessings. Lord, anoint me and anoint everyone who is watching right now, Lord. Without your Holy Spirit guidance, I will not be able to teach your kids. Without Holy Spirit anointing, they won't be able to grasp it. Let they be able to grasp it in the real truth, in real spirit and in real understanding. Let your name be glorified. Christ, my purpose tonight is not to establish anything, but to establish the name of your word. Establish the name which is above every name. Every name, every throne, every disease, every group, every power. The name of Jesus, I want to establish that name, Lord, through the preaching and the teaching of the word. Lord, let miracles, healing, powers, anointing, let it overflow in their life, Lord. As they're experiencing relationship healing right now, Lord, I pray. My good Lord is going to use them in a mighty and powerful way. Thank you, Lord. Minister us, minister to us, minister through us, Father, Lord, tonight. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, worship team, for that amazing worship. We bless you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. May you have peace over your life. May you have wonderful peace over your life. Hallelujah. Book of Romans, chapter 4. Book of Romans, chapter 4, verse 17. I want to welcome each one of you into the house of the Lord. I want to welcome each one of you into the house of the Lord. As you are watching right now, this is premiering, not live. But there are a couple of my friends and family and worship team. You have the opportunity to listen the word in advance and you can implement in your life. You can right away learn and you can implement in your life. And I want to welcome each and every person of the family. We love you. We honor you. And we are going to learn principles from the Bible. Romans, let's read Romans, book of Romans, chapter 4, verse 17.
As it is written, a father of many nations have I made you, in the presence of him whom he believed, even God who gives life to the dead and calls into being that which does not exist.
Today we are going to learn the power of declaration. The power of declarations. This is a subject many Christians doesn't understand at all. This is our third English service, and first we spoke on praying through the Bible, and last week we learned how to fast and pray effectively and why fasting is very essential in Christian life. Today we are going to learn the power of declaration. You know, I 2006 I came into Christ, and I just learned the power of declaration just 3 years back. So you can be an experienced Christian, you can be a born Christian on whatever you are, but don't realize, you may not know how to declare and how to get the blessings in your life. So if you understand this, if somebody asks, Harish, can you define your Christian life? I say, I am a product of declaration. I am a product of effective declaration. I have learned how to declare things into my life and I have seen the fruits. Today I can preach on this message with results. I have seen results. For example, when we start declaring things, various things over our life, I have seen results in my life. I have seen results in our ministry life. So I am going to teach you how to effectively decree and declare over your life, and you are going to see results. So Romans chapter 4, verse 17, we are going to learn the last portion. Who gives life to the dead and calls into existence that things do not exist. Can you read it? The version which we use.
In the presence of him whom he believed, even God who gives life to the dead and calls into being that which
Lord
does not exist.
Lord calls into things which is not there. He calls it as it is there. So how, Lord, when you decree and declare it, you say, oh, I am declaring it, I am decreeing it. You don't use it. You declare it and you calls it. When Lord calls something, he calls it with authority. He calls it with power. So you can call blessings into your life. You can call debt cancellation into your life. I'm going to share a couple of testimonies as we started using the power of declaration and how it helped us. And you can apply it in your life. I'm speaking out of my experience. You can cancel debt. You can cancel poverty. You can cancel various issues in your life. And when you speak, it is going to happen in your life. So the God whom we worship, how he calls things into existence, things which are not there. Like he called human beings to come out and it happens. The creation happens. He called and things came into existence. So you can call and you can decree and declare things into your life. How curses enters into our life? Somebody spoke the curses into our life. Somebody declared the curses into our life. So how blessings will enter into our life?
When we speak
You have to decree. You have to declare blessings into your life and things are going to enter into your life. And tonight, your life is going to change. This is going to be the most important, the life-changing sermon you have ever attended, you ever heard it in your life. So you, if you, usually in between service, I never go out and take the calls, whoever calls it. But I just went out and I took the call. I received a call from a ministry from US, United States, and a man of God I really respect. His office called and say, we want to say thank you for one thing I did. And I learned power of declaration from that man, that man's office. And when my spiritual father also, he also says, decree and declare the things you want to have in your life. So tonight we are going to learn as a family, as a church, how to decree and declare things over your life and how to see results. Isaiah 55, 10 to 11. You can say one of my favorite verses in the Bible. Isaiah 55, 10 to 11. Isaiah 55, I'm reading from English Standard Version. First, Pastor Adi is going to read. Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11.
For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there without watering the earth and making it bear and sprout and furnishing seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so will my word be which goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty without accomplishing what I desire and without succeeding in the matter for which I sent it.
When you decree and declare as an oracle of God, as a herald of God, what you need to say? As the heaven comes down from heaven and water it and the result it accomplished. The same way when I am sending a word, when I am decreeing something, it is going to accomplish the purpose which I am sending it and I am going to receive the benefit out of it. As the rain comes down and it waters the earth, rain comes and earth is the only place where we are getting rain. As of now, in human knowledge, Earth is the only place. Other places like Saturn or Venus, are we getting rain? No. So Earth, when Lord sends rain, he accomplishes some things. It waters the earth and the trees and the fruits and the farm produces and the life comes out of it. Same way, when you and I send a word, when you and I send a decree and declare, things comes out of into our life. So if you can learn, children, your life can be changed. Men and women, your life can be changed. You are going through a poverty. You are going through a troubles. You are maybe experiencing diseases and curses over your life. But if you know how to send word, how to decree and declare, your life can change tonight. Our words have power. Yes. Bible says our words have power. Your tongue has the power of life and death. So if you speak life or do you speak death over your life? You may be seeing, Pastor, I'm sitting in the night. We don't have electricity because we haven't paid the bill from last 3 months and it's gone. And I'm charging this mobile and I'm watching this service. You can decree and declare poverty to go away from your life and it will happen. I'll tell you a couple of examples which happened in our life. How judge in today, it is digital time. But earlier times, when king makes some changes in the law, the herald or the one who announced, herald means the one who announces it. He comes into the square, in the market square, and then he reads out of a scroll. He says, is it working? He reads out of a scroll and he decree and declare, this is a new law. This is a new law. That's the way we have seen in our old movies, how the herald, how the one who announces, okay, this is the new law which is king has announced and you have to follow it. And today judgment also, when judge make a judgment, he reads in the court. He has to read it, then it becomes the punishment, all the judgment of that particular scenario. So you have to speak. Human beings are the only species we are able to communicate things through our words, our tongues. Other species, other animals, they just make some sound. But human beings, only animal, only species which Lord created, we can make decree and declare it. Because he created us in his own image. So we have that power and use it. Many Christians doesn't know, many pastors doesn't know, many reverends, many bishops doesn't know how this work. And I'll teach you tonight how you have to summon it. Ezekiel, book of Ezekiel, chapter 36, verse 29. Amazing words. Ezekiel chapter 36 verse 29. I was preparing this sermon, and yesterday my Bible study is happening now on Ezekiel. I read in Ezekiel, I read Zam, various, but I was going through and I was awestruck. Lord, this is a verse, it looks like it was hidden all this time, and I never read it. I read Ezekiel at least 4 and 5 times, but this is a verse which was just lying hidden, and it's a beautiful verse. Ezekiel chapter 36 verse 29.
Moreover, I will save you from all your uncleanliness, and I will call for the grain and multiply it, and I will not bring a famine on you.
I will call grain.
The grain and multiply it.
Lord says, I am not going to create it. I am going to
call.
Call. Bible says, in my version it says, I am going to summon it. What is summoning? When you want to call somebody, you summon him. Like police gives a summon, the court gives a summon. Summon, you cannot reject it. If you reject someone from the police station, you're going to be arrested, or the police guy is going to come and take you. So when Lord gives a summon, so financial blessing, grain represents what? Food, prosperity, growth. Lord says, I am going to summon grain and no famine will come upon your life. So Lord says, I'm not going to create it. I'm going to call it into come. Romans 4:17 says, I'm a Lord who calls things into existence which is not there. So Lord doesn't go to an office job. What he does, all he does is
call.
Talk. Call. Lord sits and all he does is what? Your brother Ashwin, your boss, when he want to get something done, he want to have a tea, he go and make the tea, or he just calls it? He just calls it, because he's a boss. He runs an enterprise. He just have to call and it comes into his table. Coffee or tea or whatever he wants, it comes on his table. Think, God, who has got all the power, who created, he just have to call things into his system. And he has given us the same power to me and to you. Okay, Pastor, I want to get married to a beautiful girl and I'm going to call her into my bedroom. I'm going to call her into my house. No, that's not what I'm saying tonight. You can call wonderful blessings into your life. You can call wonderful blessings into your life, into your family life. If you want to have healing, like first English sermon we have released on the season on the English church was praying through the Bible. 107:20, if you want to have healing over your life, you can call healing. 107:20, 107 verse 20.
He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions.
He sent out his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. So if Lord want to release healing over your life, what he release?
His word.
He sent his word out. When we do healing services, when all the testimonies of healing, various blessings happening, what I have sent?
Word.
Like last week, we heard the testimony of that girl. His brother got released from the foreign jail. What I've said, you are going to have testimony this week. I expect testimony to. I send my word and my angels carried it and it happened. The prayer. So when you send, you may be having migraine, you may be having worse diseases, but you just have to send the word of healing. I decree and declare healing upon you. I decree and declare free. You're free in Jesus' name and Lord is going to honor it. You can send peace into your homes. Husband and wife, you may be quarreling right now. You can ask Lord, send peace over my household. And how we pray sometimes. We just close our eyes. Over. That's all we do. It's in my heart, Pastor. It's in my heart. I cannot express it. Tears comes down. But we don't say, we don't decree it, we don't declare it. All we say is, my eyes, see. But how to pray? You have to send your word. You have to send your word. You have to send your word. Emotional drama, there is, if you go and stand in front of the court and you do all the emotional drama, does the justice, the judge is going to listen? No, he says, when we stand in the traffic, light, there are many people and say, they come and say, I don't have this, I don't have food, and please buy from this. Do we really move out of it? I don't think so. We know that all this doing is drama. We are not going to buy it. We are just going to avoid it. And they are going to the next customer. They will walk, and when the next customer, they see, they will do all the acting. They will walk away from you, they will do all the acting. So in front of Lord, nothing, this emotional drama is not going to work. You have to take the authority, you have to decree and declare it, and you have to change the situations. Your situations will change, your situations will change. So if you want to have a healing, this church, when we had nothing, like generator or the mic, how we used to pray, we decree and declare, this year we are going to have this equipment in Jesus Christ's mighty name. You remember? And it happens, it happens, it happens. And I decree and declare we will have more wonderful equipments in this year in Jesus Christ's mighty name. More, more, more. I remember when our service was not on Facebook, we used to stand in our bedroom. We used to put our hands on the TV and we used to pray. What was, we used to pray that the broadcast, many channels, many places it is going to be broadcasted. And when people calls me, last Sunday, when the Hindi service just finished, a guy just called me, Pastor, I have sent an offering, and we are watching on the TV, and I'm hearing all the worship song which is live happening in their home. I was just finished with the sermon, and I was inside the prayer room, and I was overhearing the worship which is happening on their big screen. I've been to their home, and I know they watch Facebook on their big TV. And I already decreed and declared that many homes, many living rooms, it is going to happen before all these things happen. And it's going to happen in increase, increase. Amen. And the word I say, ours is going few thousands, but what I say, crores and lakhs and millions of homes, it is going to happen. I am already decreeing and declaring it will happen. Amen. In a year's time, when you see, I already decreed and declared. My spiritual father, he says, years back, he says, many people are going to watch our service on TV, and it is happening. So you have to decree and declare. Right now, you may not see the results. Like water comes, you don't see the, you putting the seed and it doesn't comes up right away. But you wait, the water is going to do its work and the seed is going to sprout. A small thing is going to come up and the tree is going to come up. So you have to send the word consistently, consistently. You will see results over your life. So I'm teaching you a couple of things. Mark 11:23. Leaders, you are able to follow, right? We used to do, we were doing this from years. From last 2-3 years, we decreed for things. When we were sitting on that driveway, we decreed for a bigger space. We decreed for a bigger space and we are in a bigger space. And right now, we are decreeing for bigger space. More people, more influence on the city, more influence everywhere our word is preaching, and it will happen in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Mark 11:23.
Truly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be taken up and cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says is going to happen, it will be granted to him. Therefore, I say to you, all things for which you pray and ask, believe.
Truly, I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, what?
Whoever says to this mountain.
Does it say that pastor says? Does it say that men says, women says, bishop says, reverend says, anointed says? Says whoever. So all of us are included. Whoever says to this mountain, be gone, it will be gone. So what is a mountain you are facing in your life? It can be diseases. It can be debt. It can be poverty. It can be anything. So you have to command those mountains, what you are facing, command it to go away from your life. It will go.
Amen.
Last year we were having, till now also we of, you know, our business, we have debt. But we used to command the debt to go away, command the debt to go away. And this year, I gave testimony in this church. Two of our major debts were cancelled and it was done. Two of the major debts of my business, we were able to come out of it very successfully. And favor came. When we started decreeing and declaring, it looks like nothing is going to happen. But in faith, I decreed it. In faith, I declared it. So I have experienced this. This is not something, you know, you can understand this preacher is preaching out of his experience, or just lecturing it. I preach out of my experience. And it worked for me. I pray, let it work for you and your family. So you can come out of the situations very successfully. So what you need to do? Decree and declare it. What you want to come? Nothing is going to work. What you need to do? Open your mouth, decree and declare it. Decree and declare it, it is going to happen. So whoever says, it includes all the kids, it includes the husband, the wife, the man, the person, the kids, everyone, whoever says to the mountain, so the debt you have, tell Lord, under your name, under your anointing, start worshiping and decree and declare continuously in your prayer rooms, in your church, in your worship. You know, when I say people worship, all the worship songs are declaration. When you decree and declare, Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me. What are we declaring? Jesus Christ is my Jehovah Jireh. I am not going to lack anything. He's going to supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. When the girl or the pastor, whoever is leading the worship, and all we do is, okay, 15, 20 minutes, pastor is going to come and let me get a coffee and come back. Worship is for that. Worship is, we think that it is a warming up time. No. When we say, Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me. You have to decree and declare it. His grace is sufficient for me. Hosanna. Hosanna to the highest. My King, my Lord. Hosanna. 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 So we are decreeing and declaring it when we are worshiping. So we keep on doing that. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 21. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 21. Our recording is still on, right? In Jesus' name.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruits. Those who love it. So you have to love your words. Do you love your words? Every second person I meet now, I'm into business. We're in a pharmaceutical company. So the customers and the clients I meet, every second person says, Harish, this year is gone. Don't expect anything out of this year. This is a useless year. Nothing is going to work. And the moment I hear it, I say it in my heart, no, I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. There are 120 days more in this year, and my good Lord can do. He created the heaven and earth and everything, the earth in 6 days, and the 7 day he rested. And this month, this year has got another 120 plus days. He can do wonders and he can do miracles in my life. I don't receive it. I reject those. Let me say, from March, we are under lockdown. Let me say a couple of the good things which happened in my life. Many wrong people left our ministry. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Many wrong people, those who are non-productive and wonderful girls and men and boys have entered into our life. My spiritual father says, when wrong people leave, good people enter. It happened in our ministry. Major debts of our business have been cancelled this year. Major debts. And pastors start giving into this ministry. Pastors, those who never open their wallets. Pastors, what pastors say? My father-in-law, Uncle Menon says, pastors are the good salespeople. They know without investing anything, they know how to take it out from your pocket. Without investing anything, they know how to take it out from pocket. As a pastor, I say this. My father-in-law says this. So pastors to invest and open their wallet, it is the grace of Lord. So pastors have started investing into this church. Praise the Lord. And we started going online, Facebook. Many people are getting reached. Is it a blessing? It is a blessing. Many people, the testimonies we hear, when I receive testimonies, I say, praise the Lord, Lord. I heard from you and I thank you for it. I thank you for it. And if lockdown didn't happen, just corona, I don't know. We ever go into Facebook. I don't know. So due to that situation, we started. So these are good things. This happened this year. Jesus Kitchen started happening this year. 200 people are getting fed every day. When today I was sharing with somebody, he say, this only God can do it. A non-believer, other faith, he says, one person comes into our house as a guest, we get into problem. We don't know how to feed 200 people. I say it is praise the Lord. My good Lord is making us happening. Women are coming, cooking is happening, and funds and provisions are happening. Praise the Lord. So good things are happening. And Lord opened many new financial taps into my lives, my friends, my family, blessings us. Hallelujah. Many new equipments we bought during lockdown through years, and many wonderful equipments for the church and things have come. Today also we bought a new table for me in the prayer room. Inside, I can't show you. It is in my prayer room. So we had our many staff, new staff joined this year in the ministry. Lord, full-time ministry. Many, so wonderful things have happened. So how can people say that this is a bad year? No, it's a wonderful year. And I decree and declare our enemies, our personal enemies, be it spiritual, physical, everybody is going to fail and we are going to win this year. You have to decree and you have to declare. You have to decree, you have to declare, and we will win. Yes. We are winning and we will win more, 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 more. Every month, glory to glory, we are going to glow. So what I am doing right now, I am declaring it. I am decreeing it. I am not saying. I am decreeing and I am declaring it. So you have to obey. Isaiah 54:17. It's okay to cry. I cry so much in my prayer room. When I worship, I cry. It takes a lot for me to touch 5 minutes. I cry like anything in front of the Lord. I cry, I cry, I cry. But I speak and I proclaim and I proclaim. So it is not that the cries and tears, the words have to go out of your mouth. Isaiah chapter 54 verse 17. Pastor Radhi is going to read, then I am going to read my version.
No weapon that is formed against you will prosper. And every tongue that accuses you in judgment, you will condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and the vindication is from me, declares the Lord.
That is what is Bible written. Let me read. How I read, Harish version I am going to read. No weapon that is fashioned against me shall succeed. And I shall confute every tongue that rises against me in judgment. That is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And what I add, that is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. Harish, Radhi, Eve, Abhishek, my father-in-law, Uncle Menon, Pankajam Menon, our family, our church, NIT church, our believers, our leaders. And this is the vindication from Lord, declares Lord. So this is, you can call Harish version, your version. Not you. I take words from me. So when you say you are thinking someone else is, you are giving to someone. No, it is for me. This Bible is for me. The verses are for me. So when I read, it is my version. I decree and declare. I can read like normally also. But sometimes, that's why I say to many people, read Psalms. When you're going through troubles, you don't know how to pray, read Psalms aloud. So it is a declaration. It is a decree. How I read New Testament books, like Acts or any books is happening. At the same time, I'm reading Acts just finished, and I'm reading Ezekiel, and I read Psalms, and I read Psalms is just, it is like, you know, in South Indian food, you put kadipatta and kadipatta and what is that? Nariyal in everything. Okay. So for me, Psalm is like, just like that. I read Psalms, I read Psalms, I read Psalms, I read Psalms. I decree and I declare, I decree and I declare. Because Psalms, wonderful declaration. And the most powerful weapon in the Bible is Psalms. And Isaiah has got Jeremiah also. So you have to find. So you decree and declare, you will find results. So when you go through spiritual attack, when you go through troubles and issues, what you need to say? No weapon that is fashioned against my children, Eve, Abhishek, Ephraim. No weapon that is formed against my wife, Radhi. No weapon which is formed against my church, our household. Take the name of your people, your leaders, your staff. It will never succeed. And every lying tongue. People say many lies about us. So I have a very thick skin, like hippopotamus has got very thick skin. Right? My wife never had, but now as into ministry, she's also developing that. So we get accusations, sometimes in crores a day. We get various accusations and it doesn't affect us. And we pray, just say in Hindi, people say, aapki muh ghee shakkar. So some say you got that house, you got this vehicle, you have got this much money. I pray, aapki muh ghee shakkar. May let it happen. Let it happen. And I receive those funds. I receive those amounts. Let it happen. Let it happen. Somebody is saying, you got this much money. Why to reject? Okay, yes, I receive it in Jesus Christ's mighty name. And Deuteronomy, one more verse against the devil and dark forces. Deuteronomy chapter. So develop thick skin. That's in between. Just I added kadipata. Deuteronomy 33:25-27. Do you want your enemy, dark forces, devil to do susuporti same time? This is the Bible verse. 33:25 susuporti in the English means you're doing your one and two together in toilet. Your enemy will do this when you decree and declare. Enemy is not a physical or human being, but devil and dark forces. And dark forces, devil, as Bible says in Ephesians, because of Ephesians 6, Apostle Paul says, your war is not against any man or any woman. It is against the principalities and authorities. So they only understand authority and command. They don't fear your body or the muscle. They only understand the command and the authority you carry. So under the anointing, under the Holy Spirit anointing, under the directions, when you decree and declare, things happen. Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 25-27.
Your locks will be iron and bronze, and according to your days, so will you leisurely walk be. There is none like the God of Jeshurun, who rides the heavens to your help and through the skies in his majesty. The eternal God is a dwelling place, and underneath are the everlasting arms, and he drove out the enemy from before you and said, destroy. So Israel dwells in security, the fountain of Jacob secluded, in a land of grain.
Your bars shall be iron and bronze. You can read my bars. What is written in Hindi? Does anyone having Hindi Bible right now? Can you read Deuteronomy chapter 33? Just want to know Hindi. What is it saying? Do you have Hindi? No. Yes, please. Deuteronomy 33:25 onwards, right? हाँ तेरी तेरी जूते क्या लिखा है तेरी हाँ योर बार्स बेसिकली वी पुट आयरन बार्स ब्रॉन्ज इन टू अवर गेट्स बेसिकली वी पुट बार्स सो हाउ कैन यू डिक्री एंड डिक्लेयर माय बार्स विल बी आयरन एंड ब्रॉन्ज. And as my days, so shall my strength be. There is none like God. There is none like my Jesus, O Jeshurun, who rides through the heavens to my help, through the skies in his majesty. The eternal God, Jesus, is my dwelling place, and underneath are the everlasting arms. And my Lord thrust out the enemy before me and say, destroy, destroy, destroy. So when you are facing enemy attack, when you can take those words as your and your what your God says, destroy. When Lord says destroy, it will happen. When nothing can, so and the enemy has to do susuporti at the same time. So whatever you are facing, decree and declare. Bible is the book of declarations, and I am a product of declarations. I know now to decree and declare. I now know how to decree and declare, and it will happen. So you can do all the emotional drama in front of the Lord, or you can start decreeing and declaring. And I have given you a couple of verses. So when you read like 36:29 of Ezekiel, I summon grains. So he can call grains. He can call prosperity. He's a good Lord we serve. And it happens. And I call for financial favors into this church. And I share testimonies. I don't know from where all the funds comes. It happens. He causes blessings to enter into this ministry. He causes, because we decree and we declare. Come, let us decree and declare. Can we sing the song? Jehovah Jireh, my provider. His grace is sufficient for me. We have the words. Let us decree and declare what? Jesus Christ, Yahweh is my provider. Yahweh is my provider. And he's wonderful. He's wonderful. He's wonderful. Hallelujah. By the way, what is hallelujah means? We say 1,000 times praise the Lord. But how I just learned this yesterday, so I want to share with church also. Hallelujah, the word derived from Hillel Yahweh. H-I-L-L. Hillel Yahweh. Praise Yahweh. Hillel Yahweh came. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hillel Yahweh. Hebrew word. Yahweh. Y-H-W-H. That's the way you write. Hillel Yahweh. So, just for your information, so I thought once the worship team is getting ready with the new songs which they have not prepared, so they can get some time, they can get their lyrics, and then they can start singing. Let's raise our hands towards heaven, and I pray under the anointing, under this knowledge, under the grace. Are you a servant of God? I am. I serve God. You don't need to stand on the pulpit to serve the Lord. If you do anything for the Lord, you carry the anointing of servanthood, and you are a servant of the Lord. I serve my Lord, not only on pulpit, I serve wherever He sends me. I serve my good Lord. 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 Oh, I am under the anointing, and I decree and declare, Father Lord, we are going to go into next level of growth, into personal lives, into family life, into ministry, into our business, into our career. I decree and declare, none of our family, our church members, our leaders, we are going to be into poverty. We are not going to lack any good things. Wonderful things will enter into our life. Oh, beautiful blessings will walk into our life. More financial partners will be added into this church in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Favor will come from east, west, north, and south. I pray, oh Lord, you send the angels and cause blessings to enter into my life, enter into our leaders' life, enter into our staff's life, enter into our volunteers' life, enter into our business life. Oh, you cause blessings to come upon our life. I decree and declare the anointing which is on us, let it rub on every people, every man and every woman. Oh, I serve you, Yahweh. I serve you. I serve you. I serve you. Lord, I send the word and healing every diseases which is every man and woman. Take out the name of the disease you have and say, by anointing of Jesus Christ, I receive healing on all the hormonal diseases. I receive healing on my diabetes. I receive healing on all the blockages on... A lady who is going to watch me, you are having varicosis, and my good Lord says, the moment you are going to hear it, you are going to experience this healing on your varicosis. Your veins are going to go away, oh, clear. It is not going to be seen anymore. You are going to have a beautiful leg like a young lady. Oh, I decree and declare it. You are going to have beautiful. Take your hand and touch over your calf. Oh, namariko shokota rabalaba. Lord, every varicosis vein diseases, every varicosis vein diseases, I decree and declare healing right now. Healing right now. Healing right now. Healing right now.
God shall supply all my needs according to His riches and
decree
glory.
It. Don't sing this as a song. Decree it as a promises word. Yehovah Yireh, Jesus Christ, He is going to supply all my needs, not some of my needs, not few of my needs, all of my needs, all the needs of my family, all the needs of my kitchen, all the needs of my vehicles, all the needs of my personal life, all the needs of this ministry. Yahweh, Jesus Christ, He is going to supply all my needs. Decree and declare. Decree and declare. This is not a normal song you are going to sing. You are going to decree. You are going to declare it in Jesus' name.
My God shall supply all my needs according to His riches and glory. He'll give His angel and charge over me. Yehovah Jireh cares for me. For me, for me. Yehovah Jireh cares for me.
One more time.
My God shall supply all my need according to His riches and glory. He will leave His angel and charge over me. Yehovah Jireh cares for me.
For me, for me.
Yehovah Jireh cares for me.
For me, for me.
Yehovah Jireh cares for me.
For me, for me.
Jehovah Jireh cares for me.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, His grace is sufficient for me.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, His grace is sufficient for me.
My God shall supply all my need according to His riches and glory. He will give His angels charge over me.
Jehovah Jireh cares for me.
For me, for me.
Jehovah Jireh cares.
Jehovah Jireh.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Jehovah
Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Without any music, we will sing this. Without any music, let us sing. Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Sing. The way you want to sing.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me. Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
My God shall supply.
Our provider. Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Let us include every family, every friends. Let us include everyone into this. Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Let us sing.
Jehovah Jireh, our provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Jehovah Jireh,
our provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Oh, my God
shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. He will give his angels charge over us. Jehovah Jireh, me.
Without music, just sing.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Jehovah
Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
My God shall supply all my need according to his riches and glory.
He will give his angels charge over me.
Jehovah, my Lord will give angels charge over me, so the enemy, the dark forces, the accusers, the liars will not enter into my life. Their curses, their words which they are speaking over my life and my ministry and my people's life will not have effect in Jesus Christ's mighty name. I decree and declare, I cancel every generational curses. I cancel every generational curses. I cancel every generational curses. I cancel the spirit of poverty. I cancel the spirit of debt. I cancel the spirit of quarreling. I cancel the spirit of not having peace between husband and wife, between not having peace between mom and his children. I pray her children in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Peace is going to be on the household of our families. We decree and declare it right now. As we are going to sing this song, take out your offering. As you can see on the Facebook, on the mediums, wherever you are, you can put your offerings. You can put your wonderful offerings on this account, which is displayed on the screens. You can put all your offerings, tithes offering towards Jesus Kitchen. Mention it on those accounts. You can transfer it. And if you are around from Faridabad, we would like to know more about you. Not only from Faridabad, around the globe, we would like to have a relationship with you. And thank you for being a financial partner to this church. When you pour into this ministry, my good Lord is going to cause blessings to enter into your life. Right now in Jesus' mighty name, I decree and declare it. Amen. Let us sing this song once again. Jehovah Jireh, the one who is going to multiply my blessings, the one who is going to multiply my seeds, he is my supplier. He is my supplier, and he is going to give angels charge over my life, over my kids, over my husband, over my finances, over my vehicles, over my business, over my job. He is a good Lord. He is a good Lord. He is a good Lord.
Jehovah Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
Jehovah
Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
My God
supply all my need
according to his riches and glory. He will give his angels charge over me. Jehovah Jireh cares for me.
Jehovah
Jireh, my provider, his grace is sufficient for me.
My good Lord, I decree and declare favor for your family. As month of September 2020, I decree and declare this is going to be the best month of our whole life, Lord. In finance, in blessings, in opportunity, in prosperity and in growth and in opportunities in every way, I decree and declare, Father, Lord, month of September 2020, it is going to be the best month. It is going to be the best month. It is going to be the best month of our life, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah. If you have any prayer needs, September is going to be a good month because it is the birthday of my dear daughter Eve and my dear brother Jeskarad's birthday. Hallelujah. Two of my kids' birthday. Wonderful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is going to be a wonderful month. It is going to be a wonderful month. Hallelujah. If you want to connect us, if you want to know more about our ministry's church, you can contact us any of the numbers which is displayed on the screen. And we love to know your prayers and we want to be your prayer partners over you and your family. May my good Lord cause blessings to enter into your life in this year and start decreeing and declaring. Don't be an emotional fool, I say. Decree and declare. Lord says, whoever commands this mountain, and I have given you all the authority. Jesus says, Are Baba, I have given you all the authority. Whoever is, so initiate, take that authority and release the word over your life. Bye bye, good night, praise the Lord. Jesus is Lord, Jesus is good shepherd over our life. Good night, praise the Lord, Jesus is Lord.
I see the King of Glory.